Hello guys, today we prepare at home the mozzarella cheese. Now we'll explain you all the ingredients and after why I decide to use this ingredient and why we need to use this ingredient. We will use 5 liters of fresh milk, fat fresh milk. So more is fresh, more is fat, better it is. We will add also 250 ml of fresh cream. 150 gram of yogurt, the white one, the fatty one, and also we need the rennet. This is very important. We will use 2 teaspoons of rennet. Naturally, we need also some instrument. The important one is the thermometer, one or two pot, a little bit of salt and a little bit of water. But about the salt and the water, I will explain you later. Now I will add the cream and the yogurt in the milk. We put the pots on the stove. We need to reach the temperature of 37-38 Celsius degree. Now we'll write also the Fahrenheit degree for people that use Fahrenheit. After we add the rennet, we mix very well, we close with the lid and we should wait 1 hour. During this time I will explain you why we should use this ingredient, if we find the milk from the farm, what we should do, and so on. So let's go ahead with the recipe. Ok, reach 37-38 Celsius degree, we off the fire and we add the rennet. I will use 2 teaspoons, so 2 pots, I will use 1 teaspoon each pot. Okay, after that we have add the rennet, we should mix very well, we cover with the lid and we don't touch our milk at least for 45 minutes, 1 hour. Now, waiting that the milk start the coagulation, I can explain you about the milk. What kind of milk we can use to make the cheese in general? More the milk is fresh, better it is. So this is fresh milk that I bought in the supermarket. What kind of milk we should use? The one with more fat, because already the fat is removed. This is why I add the cream. And the one that you can store less days. For example, I bought this yesterday. That was July the 7th. And expired the July the 9th. So tomorrow. So it's very fresh because you can keep in the fridge only few days. The one that you can keep at home, maybe in the fridge 1 month and outside of the fridge, is already milk that was pasteurized and they kill everything. So it's better if you find something that you can store only for few days. This one that was inside these bottles, this one is a bottle for the water, so we used to put the milk because the bottle was empty. I take it from the farmer, so it's more fresh it is better to make the cheese. Don't worry, some people ask me, if I take the milk from the farmer, I should boil it? No, because if you boil the milk, you spoil the milk. Because at home we cannot make the pasteurization, I don't know the right term, the right word, we cannot pasteurize our milk. When they pasteurize the milk, they reach the maximum temperature around 87, 89 Celsius degree, but only for 10, 15, 20 seconds. If we boil the milk, the time will be more longer, and we reach the temperature of 100 degrees when start boiling, so we spoil the milk. It's better to avoid. Don't worry, usually when you buy from the farmer, all the cow, they are checked, and plus the milk also is checked by the government. So it's very difficult that you take some disease. Plus, 100 years ago, there was no pasteurization. They take the milk from the cow directly, the goat, the sheep, they drink, or they use to make cheese. Nobody died. So we are using the milk from the time of Adam and Eve. Plus, why I use the fat cream, or the fully fat cream? I don't know, also here in different countries, they call in the different name. If you use the fresh cream, is always better, because usually when they sell the milk, they already have removed the fatty things to make the cream, to make the butter. We need also a little bit of fat to have more creamy cheese. Why we add the yogurt? Because when they treat the milk, they kill the fermenter. So we need to add some fermenter inside. The yogurt is full of fermenters. I hope that is the right name. Don't worry, if I say something wrong, check always what I write here. Because after I make the right translation, and you find the right word here. And also we need the rennet. In Italy, you can buy the rennet in the farm, in the pharmacy, sorry, online, on internet. And also you can buy in a specific shop where the farmer go to buy their stuff. Don't worry, in the comment of the video, I will put the link to buy the rennet on Amazon. Probably the link will be in Italian language, but after that you open the link, you need to switch in, there is some function that you switch in my country, and you will find something very similar in your country, and you can buy it, so you can make the cheese. So now we should wait, I say, 45 minutes, 1 hour, so see you in 30 minutes to check if our milk have made the curd or the coagulation. Okay, after 45 minutes, our curd is ready. The one made with the milk from the supermarket is soft, but the one made with the milk bought from the farmer is very, very hard, so it's perfect. Now I'll show you. So we should cut our curd, and we should wait another 15 minutes. After, we will broken the curd in small pieces, like small balls. To show you, this is the milk from the farmer. You can see, it's already cheese. The one from the supermarket, you see, is very soft. It's like yogurt. So, if you find the milk from the farmer, it's always better. See you later. Broken all the curd. Now we should on the fire again and reach the temperature of 46 Celsius degree plus, if you use Fahrenheit, this Fahrenheit degree. After we cover with the lid, we should wait, but I explain you later. So now I hope that you notice the differences from the milk from the supermarket and the milk from the farmer. I hope that we can make the mozzarella cheese also with the milk from the supermarket, but we will discover this at the end. Reach 46 degree, we off the fire, we mix our curd again, we cover with the lid and we should wait 2-3 hours, because if we want that our mozzarella cheese is very elastic, I don't know to say in English, sorry, we need to wait that the pH fall down. If we have no acid pH, the mozzarella will not be very elastic. So see you in 2-3 hours. Bye bye. After 3 hours or more, we can remove the curd from the whey. Don't throw the whey, you can use to make ricotta cheese, you can use instead of the water when you prepare the bread or the pizza dough, and you can give to your animal. Let's start with the curd that we get from the milk from the farmer. Waiting that our curd drain, we prepare the brine. So we take 1 liter of water and 150 gram of sea salt. Our brine have 50% of salt, so when you put the salt, will not melt straight away. You need to mix very well, but don't worry. It's normal, that doesn't melt because this water is cold. We need this water with the salt cold, because when our mozzarella will be ready, we will throw in the cold water to have firm mozzarella cheese. In this pot I put already 3 liters of water. Now we on the fire and we should reach the temperature of 80-90 Celsius degree. When the water is hot, we take a piece of curd and we will try with the hot water. If the curd melt, means that it's ready, so we can make our mozzarella cheese. our mozzarella cheese is very elastic, so we can go ahead with the recipe. Now I will cut the other curd in small slices. I will throw this water because now it's already cold, and we will add the other water. When the mozzarella cheese will melt and will be very elastic and very shiny, we can shape our mozzarella cheese and throw in the water with the salt. After that, we have used the milk from the farmer, we will try to do the same thing with the milk from the supermarket. You can see that the mozzarella start to melt, but also that I can put my hand inside the water. So this means that the water is already cold. So now I will throw this water. I will put other 3 or 4 cups of hot water, and we'll go ahead with the recipe. I don't speak anymore because if not, I cannot finish my mozzarella cheese. Maybe I will tell something at the end. Our mozzarella cheese are ready. They are not so perfect, sorry, but also doing the video is always a mess. You can give to the mozzarella cheese different shape. There is also the classic one. So now I will throw this water because it's already cold. I will use the other hot water with the other curd here. A little bit confused. But I don't know if with this curd we will have a good result. So let's try it. Unfortunately, with the milk that I bought in the supermarket, I was not able to make the mozzarella cheese melt, but not enough to have the mozzarella cheese. So what to do? Don't give up. You can try again. You can try to find the real milk from the farmer. This one, if you try to make some experiment at home, don't throw away because it's still cheese. So you take a towel. I don't know, like this, now this is dirty. You pour inside your cheese, the whey will go out, and the things that remain in the towel will be cheese. So you can eat cheese also if it's not mozzarella cheese. How to preserve the mozzarella cheese? You take a glass jar like this one, you put 8 tablespoon of water, 1 tablespoon of bran, and 1 tablespoon of whey. You close your jar and you store in the fridge at least 4-5 days, 1 week maximum. So now I put my mozzarella cheese inside the jar, and the other one I will test for you. Spectacular. Okay guys, see you in the next video. Remember to subscribe to the channel, to leave me a like, to share this video with your friends. For any question, any suggestion, down in the comments. Bye bye. Spectacular.